Mark, thank you. Several of our producers here going, we're Team PETA. He was PETA, of course, in Hunger Games and also featured in Hulu's Futurama, a bunch of stuff. Labor Day weekend, you can watch all four Hunger Games movies for free. Josh Hutcherson is here to tell us all about that. And has Josh become more handsome during the quarantine? The answer is yes. Sir, how are you? How have you held up during the last couple months?
Sam, thank you. Oh my God, my ego just got a nice little kiss on the cheek. That was sweet. It's been weird. It's been a weird few months, obviously. I think everybody's going through a different version of it. I've been fortunate and lucky in my situation to have, you know, a bit of space and have my dogs with me and everything. So that's been nice, but there's a lot of people going through a really hard time right now. So I'm constantly thinking about that. And so it's a difficult moment for sure.
Yeah. You know what? You're absolutely right. Let me ask you this. First movie came out 8 years ago, and I remember literally the mania of those LA Live premieres and that kind of thing replicated all around the world.
Oh, yeah.
Does that seem like a lifetime ago or just last week?
It seems like a lifetime ago. It really does. I mean, those are some of the more memorable, like embroidered into my brain moments of my life, doing the press tours for the Hunger Games and the shooting of the Hunger Games and everything. It's weird. I never thought that I'd say that I would miss those mania moments, but there's a certain rush, and that now thinking back on it years later, it's like it felt good. It's scary and it's intense, but it's like it's dynamic and it's something that it's you got to try it, Sam.
What I think is cool about it is it's totally organically elevated from the fans. It wasn't like, hey, some studio is going to spend $1 billion to make this happen. In the most genuine way, the fans made
completely.
It happen. Which I think is...
Yeah, I mean, look, the Hunger Games fans, you know, before we even started filming, were rabid. And, you know, so they were with us through it all the way to the end. And every city that we showed up in across the world, whether it's Rome or Paris, L.A., middle of Texas, New York, they were just... The fans were so passionate, so loud, and that energy... honestly, is what made us have the energy to keep going and doing these tours and making these movies. It was exhausting, but they were the best. Are the best.
We got a clip from Catching Fire, and then we're going to learn what Tubi's doing. Here we go.
All right.
If you die, and I live, I'd have nothing. Nobody else that I care about.
PETA.
It's different for you. Your family needs you. You have to live. For them.
I'm breaking out the Puffs Plus. There were these emotional moments that really resonated within the series. What's up with Tubi and the Hunger Games coming up for the weekend?
Yeah, so Tubi is this new service that I'm just learning about, actually, that has 23,000 titles to stream, movies, TV shows, and everything for free. And they have an amazing catalog of stuff, and now they're adding Hunger Games to it. And you literally just go to the website, sign up, sign in for free, and then you watch it. And it's fantastic. And so now it's going to be available on Tubi, all four of them. You can watch them back to back. You can pause and go to the bathroom. You can have a meal between. You can spread out over a couple of days, whatever you want. And have it your way. That's the way that's Burger King. It's not Tubi.
And are you the type of person, when was the last time you watched?
Oh, boy. I actually haven't watched them since the premieres. I can't. It's hard for me to watch myself. You know, I like to, like, make it, hope people enjoy it, but then never look at it again. If I watch it, I'll be critical, and you know, that's that. But actually, I was thinking, it's been enough time now. I'm far enough away from it. They're really good movies. I should maybe try to watch them again and just remove myself as much as possible.
I remember so vividly being in the screening rooms for those movies and this hush before it started, and you know, just this unbelievable degree of anticipation. Talk to me quickly, Josh, about Future Man on Hulu. Final season. Anything ahead, or are you happy with the way Future Man turned out?
Yeah, I'm super happy with Future Man. That show was a whirlwind of a ride, and that group of people was incredible and hilarious, and I never knew it was coming my way. But yeah, the last season just came out in the beginning of the pandemic. That's how I, like, chronicle things now. It's like pre-pandemic, mid-pandemic. We're not post-pandemic yet, but that's my next step. But yeah, it came out in the beginning of the pandemic, the final season, and it's weird and funny. It's on Hulu. And yeah, it's another fun one to watch and pass some time for sure.
All right. Well, we'll tell folks, it's really nice to talk to you, Josh. Thank you so much that you can download Tubi now, any
awesome.
Device.
Thank you.
TubiTV.com. You can stream Hunger Games, all four films for free. You can do that starting today, Josh Hutcherson there. Frank and Jessica, over to the two of you.